Joe, that's not an Arc Flash label. What are you putting on that MCC?
Well, there's a new requirement for some machinery and equipment like MCCs. It's all based comparing the fault current in your power system at the point where your equipment is installed to the rating of the equipment. It's a system thing, so you have to know how all the components work together, not just individually, like you would compare a circuit breaker's KA rating to the available fault current.
All right, who's requiring that? I didn't hear about that at my old job.
Well, it's an NEC thing. Here, let me show you.
Did you know that the new edition of the National Electrical Code, or the NEC, has been released? And with it, there are additional requirements that affect how short circuit protection is applied to your equipment and machinery. Previous editions already required industrial control panels to be marked with their short circuit current rating, or SCCR. But as of 2017, the NEC requires that the available short circuit current, also known as the available fault current, be marked on the following equipment: machinery, HVAC and elevator control equipment, generator and transfer equipment, energy storage equipment, and battery systems. The NEC also requires that the available short circuit current be documented for motor control centers and any other equipment with an industrial control panel. So have you reviewed the ratings on your existing industrial control panels, as well as your specifications for new equipment that you'll be purchasing in the future? Have you or your utility made modifications that may impact the available short circuit current throughout the power distribution system in your facility? Equipment SCCR ratings stay the same, but the available fault currents may change based upon system changes or if you move that equipment to a new location. You could be left with an inadequate SCCR rating. If you're not sure of your equipment's existing short circuit current rating, or if you want your specifications to ensure no future SCCR problems, or maybe you're just not sure how to address these changes, don't worry, Eaton's here to help. We help customers every day with SCCR, and we can help you navigate through your evaluations. We've developed a three-step approach for compliance. Step one, know the range of potential fault current where equipment may be or will be installed. Step two, specify and design equipment SCCR for the highest available fault current or with an alternate bill of material to address the high available fault currents. Step three, for an end user, ensure that the SCCR ratings exceed your available fault current in your facility. For the OEM, review the weakest links in the assembly and address them with new solutions that will increase the SCCR rating. Let's look at each of these steps in more detail. Step one, know the available short circuit current. It's important to be prepared because it's very difficult to fix inadequate SCCR once your equipment is installed. This means that your first step is knowing your target SCCR value in the design phase. Remember, you're working with a system that has many parts. As a manufacturer of electrical equipment, Eaton provides components and assemblies with a number of options when it comes to equipment ratings. We, like many other OEMs, rely on the specification to tell us what rating is adequate for the installation. FC Squared can help. FC Squared is Eaton's mobile app that helps you easily calculate available fault currents anytime and anywhere. This tool is a free download available in the Apple App Store or in the Google Play Store for the Android. Step two, specify and/or design your equipment. Once you know the available short circuit currents for the application, you'll need to make sure the equipment SCCR is sufficient. Eaton can help you select the right equipment and write the specifications that will work for your unique applications. We have to understand what SCCR is for the proper selection and application of equipment. Let's use an analogy here. Imagine a weightlifter getting ready to bench press. And I hope you picture two people in this scenario, because when bench pressing, you should always have a spotter. It's all about safety. You see, the weightlifter is the electrical equipment. The weights are the forces that short circuit currents can place on that equipment. And the spotter, well, there's your overcurrent protective device. Let's say, for example, I had this guy. standing next to me. Who do you think could bench press 500 pounds without doing damage to himself? You see, this guy's built for that type of weight, and well, I'm not. Some electrical equipment can come with high short circuit current ratings because they were designed that way. But what if I told you I, too, can bench press 500 pounds? And then asked this guy to be my spotter. When I lay down on that bench and look up, and he's standing over me, well, 500 pounds is nothing. Because basically he's doing all the work. I never really see 500 pounds, but I can always say that I can bench press 500 pounds when spotted by this guy, and not this guy. This is very much like electrical equipment. SCCR ratings can be achieved, but inevitably your SCCR rating will be dependent upon an upstream or integral overcurrent protective device that takes the pressure off of the equipment for those high fault currents. You always have to ask yourself, who's your spotter? Step 3, compare the SCCR to the available fault current. For end users, specify the right SCCR knowing the available fault current for your facility. For OEMs, applying the rules to calculate the panel SCCR can be challenging. That's where OSCR comes in. OSCR is a tool that calculates and documents assembly SCCR for control panels. This helps you validate the proper way to apply the components to reach your new short circuit current rating. Along with these available tools, Eden provides free SCCR analysis for your control panel designs, as well as solution options to help you achieve the SCCR you require. SCCR is a serious issue that deserves your attention. Inadequately rated equipment can be the cause of an arc flash issue and can cause serious personnel injury and equipment damage. Properly rated equipment and arc flash analysis work together to increase electrical safety. Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we can help you determine the best course of action to address SCCR for your power system. As a quick recap, here are 3 key things to remember. 1, the 2017 National Electrical Code, among other things, requires that you mark or document the available short circuit current on your equipment. 2, Eden is equipped with the tools and support services to help you prepare for these changes. Get started today by downloading FC Squared or talk to your local sales representative. And if you're an OEM, download OSCR. 3, our experts can walk you through the process from concept to completion to help ensure that your equipment is both compliant and safe. Contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today and to learn more about SCCR. Eaton is well equipped to help you ensure that your equipment is compliant and your customers' employees are safe. Count on Eaton to help you protect what matters most. ¶¶